Few celebrity breakups are as controversial as the ever-unfolding drama between Johnny Depp and Amber Heard. Most people I know are either Team Johnny or Team Amber, and they've spent a lot of time discussing about who the real abuser in the troubled relationship is. However, Johnny Depp has been trying to warn everyone about Amber Heard and who she is for real. Over the past several months, we've heard from Depp's friends, fans, and exes who all claim he could have never mistreated Amber because of his sweet and gentle nature. And there's been many doubts cast upon Heard, leading people to think she's a core abuser, a narcissistic gold digger, and ultimately, a liar. Adding to this, we have Johnny Depp's hints and attempts to tell the truth about his ex-wife. We like to imagine that the real abuser is always some sort of an obvious monster, and that we are not going to be manipulated by any wolves in sheep's clothing. Do you remember that message to Johnny Depp's fans when he jokingly was saying, "I'm scared to death, I'm frightened and I don't know what to do, I'm confused and I want to go home"? This phrase made everyone laugh. But what if it was Johnny's cry for help? He couldn't tell anyone what was going on between him and Amber Heard before the legal fight, as he's a good person and he didn't want to show people their dirty laundry. The myth of the obvious abuser was very convenient for Amber Heard, and of course, eventually, it did more harm than good, even for Amber. People easily wind up defending their guilty friends and blame the victims. We might mistake self-defense and coping mechanisms by victim as proof of their crimes. Victims of domestic violence may even use violence themselves against their abusers, and it may be very difficult for outsiders to establish which person is the primary abuser and which person is the primary victim. Johnny Depp was trying to warn everyone she was a liar, but he couldn't prove he wasn't guilty. Amber Heard had a strong tactic, to lie in court. But eventually, body language experts analyzed the video back in 2016 court deposition. First, everyone thought Amber Heard behaved really weird because she was stressed and scared. But according to body language experts, she just behaved like a typical liar. Being a real man, Johnny Depp didn't tell anyone what happened with his finger for real, and was even trying to hide facts and lie to his friends about the incident. Obviously, he wanted to protect Amber Heard. During the Venice Film Festival 2015 conference, Dakota Johnson obviously asked Johnny Depp about his finger. Johnny answered vaguely. He avoided the question with a joke, but it seems Dakota didn't believe him. She knew something was wrong. Just notice Dakota give him a look that says she knows more than he lets on. You might remember the story about Amber Heard's dogs and that she had some problems with them. In July 2015, Amber Heard brought Yorkshire Terriers Pistol and Boo to the country illegally. And to avoid problems, Amber Heard asked her former employee Kevin Murphy to lie under oath after she was charged with bringing her two dogs to Australia illegally. Murphy claimed Heard pressured him to commit perjury about the traveling terriers or risk losing his job. "She wanted me to say essentially that it was my fault in one way or another that the paperwork wasn't completed so that I could take the blame for her," Murphy said. And of course, she asked Johnny Depp to help with the problem. Isn't it a warning sign of abuse? But probably Johnny Depp had to go along with everything Amber wanted because he truly loved her. But she literally forced Johnny to help her with the problem, and he got in trouble as a result. To understand that Amber Heard had too much control over Johnny Depp, just take a look at the photo shoot moments. Being very attentive, you can see that the two would have body language that would showcase that something was wrong. Take a look at Amber Heard's body language in just about every photo she ever took with Johnny Depp. He was very much into her, draping an arm around her and leaning in towards her, and all the while being victimized by her. She, on the other hand, leaned away from him or tipped her head. Even when she tried to fake a public display of affection for him, she turned her face away with a vaguely veiled look of disgust. She clearly enjoyed the spotlight, but I couldn't find a single photo where she was enjoying him. Moreover, so many experts were analyzing their mutual photos, and everyone said Amber was over-controlling, as it was already said before. However, all kinds of body language experts noted that she was lying solely by how she composed herself and moved around. Anyways, Johnny Depp has claimed Amber Heard made him follow strange rules during their marriage. He claimed the slightest upset would cause an argument between them, including one row that kicked off when he took off his boots without her permission. He gave examples of what he called her controlling behavior. Depp said, "Miss Heard was in the habit when I returned home from work, she would come over to me and take my boots off for me. I always thought it was a very kind, loving gesture. One time I came home and she was busy doing something, so I took my own boots off. She said to me, 'Why did you do that? take your own boots off. And she was upset. Depp also claimed that when they would lie together on the sofa in the evening, she felt she had to put his hand on her in a certain way to please her. He said she had rules, and if he didn't comply, all hell would break loose. The actor explained, she had a routine, and if that routine is not to her standard, then there's going to be a problem. An argument would ensue. All hell would break loose. However, the times when Amber Heard was insulting Johnny Depp is really easy to count. Another really huge fight happened during their trip to the Bahamas in 2015. The couple were staying on the island, and Tara Roberts, who was the pair's employee, heard an argument that Johnny Depp and Amber Heard had. Tara Roberts claimed she had seen Ms. Heard screaming at and berating the actor as he yelled at her to go away. Ms. Roberts, who has worked for Johnny Depp since December 2008, added that she saw a red, swelling gash on his nose and had told her that Ms. Heard had thrown a can of lacquer thinner into his face. And she actually told the court about the entire situation in her statement. She said, "While I could not hear what caused the fight, Amber repeatedly berated him with increasingly ferocity. She was insulting him, calling him names, and in the middle of this onslaught, I heard her say specifically, 'Your career is over. No one is going to hire you. You're washed up, fat. You will die a lonely man,' and also screaming things that were incomprehensible." Ms. Roberts claimed Mr. Depp tried to leave, repeatedly asking for the key to a vehicle, which Ms. Heard refused to give back, adding it was later found in the couple's house. She said during the entire incident, she never saw Mr. Depp hit or push Ms. Heard, and nor did he physically react to the attacks. She said, "On walking Mr. Depp to a cafe later on, she saw he had a red, swelling gash on the bridge of his nose." Ms. Roberts claimed she did not see any signs of injury on Ms. Heard's face or body during the trip. So it seems like all this time, Johnny Depp was the one who really needed help. So it's taken a while to get to the point to where things are finally starting to come together. Putting two and two together makes us think that Amber Heard is likely to be the bad guy in this story. But will it be enough? Only time will tell. Now, tell me your opinion about Amber Heard. Do you think she's the one who abused Johnny, or is she the victim? And do you think that there are still so many shade things we don't know about Amber Heard? Let me know what you think in the comments down below.
Seen anything that would indicate to me he is anything other than a beautiful human being?
You can keep Barbosa?